Welcome to Pulaski Heights United Methodist Church, and thank you for being a part of our television ministry. Pulaski Heights is a place of warmth and love, with an outreach mission that extends far beyond our church walls. We have a long tradition of offering our hearts, stretching our minds, and extending Christ's hands to those in need. We are a congregation of hope and an open place of worship that seeks to share the good news beyond the conventional barriers of fellowship.
Good morning and welcome to Pulaski Heights United Methodist Church. My name is John Robbins. We are excited that you are a part of our service of worship today as we have this special festival service of lessons and carols. We are thankful for your presence and we appreciate very much your willingness to be a part of something so special on this unique and powerful Sunday of worship.
Once in Rome.
Mary was that mother.
Let us pray. Beloved in Christ, be it this Advent season our care and delight to prepare ourselves to hear again the message of the angels, and in heart and mind to go even unto Bethlehem to see this thing which has come to pass and the babe lying in a manger. Therefore, let us hear again from Holy Scripture the tale of the loving purposes of God from the first days of our sin unto the glorious redemption brought us by this holy child. And let us make this sanctuary glad with our carols of praise. But first, because this of all things would be a rejoice of his heart, let us pray to him for the needs of the whole world and all his people. For peace upon the earth he came to save. For love and unity within the one church he would build. For unity and goodwill among all people. And particularly at this time, let us remember before him the poor, the cold, the hungry, the oppressed, the sick and them that mourn, the lonely and the unloved, the aged and the little children, all those who know not the Lord Jesus, or who love him not, or who by sin have grieved his heart of love. Lastly, let us remember before him them who rejoice with us, but upon another shore and in a greater light, that multitude which no one can number, whose hope was in the Word made flesh, and with whom in this Lord Jesus we forevermore are one. These prayers and praises let us humbly offer to the throne of heaven in the words which Christ himself has taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. The Almighty God bless us with his grace. Christ give us the joys of everlasting life. And unto the fellowship of the citizens above, may the King of angels bring us all. Amen.
Chapter 4, John the Baptizer appeared in the wilderness, proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. We light these candles as a symbol of Christ, the way. May the word sent from God through the prophets lead us in the way of salvation. O come, Emmanuel. Draw near to the light of Christ through sharing his peace with one another by saying, the light of the world is coming to you. The light of the world is coming to you. Amen.
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 Redeemer, come with us, abide. Our hearts to thee are open wide. Let us thy inner presence feel, thy grace and love in us reveal.
First lesson, Genesis 3, 8 through 15. God announces in the Garden of Eden that the descendant of woman shall bruise the serpent's head. They heard the sound of the Lord God walking in the garden at the time of the evening breeze, and the man and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God among the trees of the garden. But the Lord God called to the man and said to him, "Where are you?" He said, "I heard the sound of you in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, and I hid myself." He said, "Who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten from the tree of which I commanded you not to eat?" The man said, "The woman whom you gave to me to be with me, she gave me the fruit from the tree, and I ate." Then the Lord God said to the woman, "What is this that you have done?" The woman said, "The serpent tricked me, and I ate." The Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, cursed are you among all animals and among all wild creatures. Upon your belly you shall go, and dust you shall eat all the days of your life. I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your offspring and hers. He will strike your head, and you will strike his heel." The word of the God for people of God.
Bleak midwinter, frosty wind made moan. Earth stood hard as iron, water like a stone. Snow had fallen, snow on snow. In the bleak
Jesus.
Second lesson, Isaiah 9, 2, and 6 and 7. Isaiah foretells the birth of a child who will bring endless peace. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Lesson, Micah 5, 2 through 4. The prophet Micah foretells the glory of little Bethlehem. But you, O Bethlehem of Ephratah, who are one of the little clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me one who is to rule in Israel, whose origin is from of old, from ancient days. Therefore he shall give them up until the time when she who is in labor has brought forth. Then the rest of his kindred shall return to the people of Israel, and he shall stand and feed his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God, and they shall live secure. For now he shall be great until the ends of the earth. The word of God for the people of God.
Thank you.
Bethlehem. Far away I heard a shepherd boy piping on the way to Bethlehem. Angels in the sky brought this message nigh. Dance and sing for joy that Christ, the newborn King, has come to bring us peace on earth, and he's lying cradled there at Bethlehem. Tell me, shepherd boy, piping tunes so merrily on the way to Bethlehem. Who will hear your tunes on these hills so lonely on the way to Bethlehem? Angels in the sky brought this message nigh. Dance and sing for joy that Christ, the newborn King, has come to bring us peace on earth, and he's lying cradled there at Bethlehem. None may hear my pipes on these hills so lonely on the way to Bethlehem, but a king will hear. Shepherd boy piping merrily, is he there at Bethlehem? I will find him soon by the star shining brightly in the sky or Bethlehem. Angels in the sky brought this message nigh. Dance and sing for joy that Christ, the newborn King, has come to bring us peace. He's lying cradled there at Bethlehem. May I come with you, shepherd boy, piping merrily, come with you to Bethlehem. Pay my homage too at the new King's cradle. Is it far to Bethlehem? Angels in the sky brought this message nigh. Dance and sing for joy that Christ, the infant King, is born this night in lowly stable yonder, born for you at
Bethlehem. Thank you.
24th lesson, Luke 1, 26 through 35 and 38. The angel Gabriel appears to the Virgin Mary. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give him to the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed her. The word of God for the people of God.
Who claim the faith of Jesus, sing the wonders that were done when the love of God the Father over sin the victory won, when he made the Virgin Mary mother of his only Son. Blessed were the chosen people out of whom the Lord did come. Blessed was the land of promise fashioned for his earthly home. But more blessed for the mother, she who bore him in her.
Fifth lesson, Luke 2, 8 through 20, the shepherds go to the manger. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told to them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen as it had been told to them. The word of God for the people of God.
Us at Bethlehem, on a night you know of them. We were only creatures small, hid by shadows on the wall. We were swallow, moth and mouse, the child was born in our house, and the bright eyes of us three peeped at his nativity. Hands of peace upon that place, hush our beings for a space, quiet feet and folded wing, nor a sound of anything. With a moving star we crept closer when the baby slept. Men who guarded where he lay moved to frighten us away. But the babe awake and made love on things that were afraid. With so sweet a gesture he called us to his company.
Sixth lesson, Matthew 2, 1 through 11. The wise men are led by a star. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem asking, "Where is this child who had been born made king of the Jews? For we observed his star at its rising and have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet. And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means the least among the rulers of Judah. For from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel." Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word so that I may also go and pay him homage." When they had heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chest, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. The word of God for the people of God.
Your gifts are very important to our ministries. Because you give, Pulaski Heights United Methodist Church continues the rich tradition of always providing excellent music arts, and worship to its members and the community. We have several ways for you to give your offerings today. As you can see on the screen, use our text to give option, give online, give by mail, or you may give by electronic funds transfer. The Lord be with you and also with you. Let us pray. God of wonder, during this special season of Advent, we give thanks and rejoice in the gifts of family and friends who offer strength and support that make our lives worthwhile. In the spirit of hope and expectancy, we pray your blessings upon the church as we look forward to celebrating the birth of the Christ child. Teach us to expect a message from angels, praise from shepherds, gifts from hidden places, and your kingdom born among ordinary people. Hear our prayers for persons in need. Let us care for one another and be mindful of those who enter this season not with a sense of gladness. Hear our prayers for all experiencing grief and loss this day, and our Christian sympathy is extended to Reggie Ott and family in the death of her mother, Debbie Atchley, to Maddie Polk and family in the death of her mother, Carolyn Polk, to Darlette Ellis and family in the death of her uncle, Bartlett Bale, and to W.A. McCormick and family in the death of his mother, Catherine McCormick. And we pray for all who are ill or recently hospitalized, including Brenda Collier, Gwen Eifert, Dr. Trey Gross, Faye Jean Royce, Chris Marine, Jack Stanley, and Carolyn York. God of love, as we present our tithes and offerings today, may we be generous as you fill us with the joy and peace of this season. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Heart
Please stand. The seventh lesson, St. John unfolds the great mystery of the Incarnation. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him, yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood or of the will of the flesh or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us. And we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. This is the Word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
And light.
may he who by his incarnation gathered into one things, earthly and heavenly, fill you with the sweetness of inward peace and goodwill, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, be upon you and remain with you always. Amen. We say to all of you, God bless you. Have a great week. Walk with Jesus. And tell somebody about Pulaski Heights United Methodist Church.
That Jesus Christ is
Thank you for joining us today at Pulaski Heights United Methodist Church. And I hope you enjoyed our worship service. May the peace, joy, and love of God be with you.